Hi students of class 3, today we will start a new chapter of maths, chapter 3, Roman numbers. First I will explain the chapter with the help of the book and then we will continue the class. So everyone open page number 20 and take a pencil in your hand. I think everyone has opened the book, page number 20. So let's start. The Roman numeral system is the most ancient and a popular system of writing numbers. It was developed by the Romans thousands of years ago. So this Roman numeral was first developed or invented by the Romans thousands of years ago for writing different types of numbers. Next, in this system, 7 letters of alphabets are used to represent the numbers. What are the 7 letters that are used? I, V, X, L, C, D, M. Now, what the numbers these letters are represented? I represent 1, V represent 5, X represent 10, L represent 50, and C represent 100, D represent 500, M represent 1000. I will request everyone to memorize this table because we need all these letters for doing the numerical problems of Roman numbers. Now, let us once again remind the numerical values of each letters. I represent 1, V represent 5, X represent 10, L represent 50, C represent 10, D represent 500, and M represent 1000. There is no letter to represent 0 in the Roman number system. So there is no concept of writing the letter number 0 in the Roman numeral system. Now why this numeric Roman numbers are used? Romans used this Roman numbers to represent the faces of the clock, to list important topics in outline. That means for heading giving, Romans use these Roman numbers to represent the numbers. All the numbers are written using either a single letter or a combination of different letters. So, in each Roman numeral, we can see a single letter or can we see a combination of different letters. Now, let us learn how to represent numbers from 1 to 50 using the Roman numeral system. There are certain rules to follow for writing the Roman numerals. So, let us see that first. Rule 1. If a symbol is repeated more than one time, then we add its numeric value that many times. That means 1, 1, I is represented 1 plus 1, that means 2. When we write I, that means it represents 1 plus 1 plus 1, that means 3. When we represent X, that means it represent 10 plus 10, that means 20. XX is representing 20. XXX, that means 10 plus 10 plus 10 equals to 30. That means XXX represent the numeric number 30. Now, only letters I, X, C, and M can be repeated. Letters X, I, C, M are only repeated, but the letters V, L and D are never repeated. V, L and D are never repeated. So, 10 is not written as V, V. Rather, it is represented as X. I think till here the sums are clear to all. Now let us move to the next page, that is page number 20. Sorry, 21. Now, the symbol cannot be repeated more than 3 times in a row. That means a symbol that are repeated. That means which symbols are repeated? I, X, C and M. These letters or symbols are repeated, can be repeated not more than 3 times. Suppose as we represent 3, I, but for writing 4, we can't use I. 4 times I we cannot represent. Like for 30, we represent XXX, but for 40, we can't represent XXXX. 4 times X we cannot represent. I think the rule is clear to all. Let me recap the rule once again, as much we have done. If a symbol is repeated more than 1 times, then we add the numeric value that many times. Only the letter I, X, C, M are repeated, but the letters V, L, D are never repeated. The symbol cannot be repeated more than 3 times in a row. Only for 3 times we can repeat the particular symbols, that are I, X, C and M. But we cannot repeat this symbol more than 3 times. Now coming to the next rule. When a letter having smaller value is written to the right of letter having greater value, add the numeric value of the smaller letter to the numeric value of the greater letter. That means, let us see the example. V, I. That means V represent 5 and I represent 1. Whenever the smaller letters are represented to the right of the greater letter, we have to add the values. Is it clear? 5 plus 1 equals to 6. VI represent 6. XI. I is smaller than X. So, and it is represented to the right of X. So, X represent 10, I represent 1. So 10 plus 1 equals to 11. In this way, this happens. Let us see 2 more examples. LI. I is smaller than L and it is represented to the right of L. So 50 plus 1 equals to 51. CI. I is smaller than C and it is represented to the right of C. So, C represent 100, I represent 1. So, 100 plus 1 equals to 101. XV. V is smaller than X and it is represented to the right side of X. So, X represent 10, V represent 5. 10 plus 5 equals to 15. In this way, this rule is followed. Let me recap this rule once again. Whenever a smaller value is represented to the right of a greater value, That means the smaller value is added to the greater value. Rule number 3. When a letter having smaller value is written to the left of a letter having greater value, subtract the numeric value of the smaller letter from that of the greater letter. So, this rule was having smaller letter to the right hand side. Now, we will see the smaller letters in the left hand side. So, when any smaller letter is represented to the left hand side of a greater letter, that means the value is subtracted from the greater letter. So IV means I is 1, V is 5. So the value of I is smaller than V and it is represented to the left hand side of the greater letter. That means we have to subtract the value of I from V. That means 5 minus 1 equals to 4. Let us see one more example. IX. I is smaller than X and it is represented to the left hand side of the X. So, I represent 1, X represent 10. That means 10 minus 1 equals to 9. IX represent 9. Next, XL. X is smaller than L because the value of X is 10 and the value of L is 5. And X is represented to the left hand side of L. So, we have to subtract the smaller value from the larger value. That is 50 minus 10 equals to 40. XL represent 40. I think these rules are clear to all. This second rule and third rule is a bit difficult to understand, but it is easy if you practice. Let me recap these two rules once again. Whenever smaller letters are represented to the right hand side of the greater letters, that means we have to add the two values. But when the smaller letters are represented to the left of the greater letter, we have to subtract the smaller letter value from the greater letter value. The two rules, I think it is clear to all. So now, everyone will read these rules from the book as I have done for you, and then please everyone practice writing the numbers from 1 to 20 in your Maths CW copy for homework. In the CW, what we have done? I have done what are Roman numerals, why Roman numbers are used, what are the different letters used for Roman numbers, what are the numeric value of those Roman numerals, and the rules that are used for writing the Roman numerals. This thing I have done today for CW, and the HW work I have given you to write the Roman numbers from 1 to 20 in your Maths CW copy. I want to see how much rule you have understood, and using those rule you will write the numbers. Now, this is your HW work for today. Everyone do the HW in the CW copy and send me the HW at dphahelpdesk@gmail.com. If any query is there, please write in the comment box. you.
So, after finishing the HW, please send me the work at dphjhelpdesk@gmail.com for correction. Stay at home, do your work. Bye-bye.